Welcome everyone to Operation Brooding Sleep. We are forced to investigate the wilderness of the eastern United States to go into yet another facility. One with four bleeps, so it's heavily guarded, and the aliens are also producing new facilities, which sucks a little bit, but yeah, what can you do? It is what it is. We are at the moment pretty much set. We are ready to conquer the remaining world, and we're just waiting for our Psy operatives to finish their trainings. Now, we had a question. What do I think about the workshop? The workshop as a building is good. You can use it, but it will slow down your progress, but once you have built it, you will have more resources available, if that makes sense. It is, however, a little bit problematic in very difficult environments. I would shy away from the workshop because you're making the early game even more difficult, and then you're getting over the hill faster than once it's built. So if you're having trouble in the early game, apparently I wouldn't go for a workshop, but if you're all fine and it's just snowballing your way, workshop is the way to go. You can also put weapon upgrades on the bolt caster using a bug. Okay, how does that work? Closing on target position now. Not that we're abusing bugs, but I'm still interested how it works. Superior expanded magazine plus bolt caster. Yeah, that would definitely be something I would be interested in. Although it only would have four shots, the weapon would really, really, really be good. We can almost hear the sectopod. Good, so slowly but surely, let's make our way into this direction. Just trying to put everyone into a good position. Interestingly enough, there's the first enemy. You need to go to the weapon upgrades for a different soldier, then press the left and right keys. Oh, that is tricky, my friend. That is tricky. Okay, we're going to be spotted out. Any slot altering mod will also do additional weapon slots, Grimmy loots. Yeah, I know that Grimmy's loot would definitely work. We don't have enough room to position everyone. I don't want to pull two packs, but I also do not. I'm definitely not going to back up just because they are advancing here. Okay, I've thought about it. I guess I just missed micro in the late game. Some kind of experience of too much shit is going on the missions. Okay. Usually the end game is the easier part of it, so you shouldn't have that much of a problem. I mean, just look how we are doing the encounters here. You should have a similar equipment and just do the encounter the exact same way. I can do the next mission if you want with only standard equipment. So we're just taking a normal equipped group, no special equipment. So that will work for you. Nice. Damn, we do have a lot of extra abilities. Okay, okay. So, what's it gonna be, gentlemen? I think we're going to use our reposition to go here. Lightning shot, just out of interest. We could also reposition to here. Yeah, we are repositioning to here. Lightning shot and one shot to him. He'll die. Oh no, he's going to split. Never mind. That's not a good idea. I wanted to fan fire him. We could shotgun kill him. If we block this spot and kill him, then he can't get up. He would need to walk all the way around, so he would be useless. So we're repositioning to here. Killing him and killing this guy. Shotgun kill on him. No, shotgun kill probably on her. How are we going to kill him? Maybe by moving over here. Shot, shot, kill. Okay, ooh, that's a long shot. Let's see how we're starting with that. We could also haywire protocol and just make sure that this guy is going to be stunned. Yeah, which is probably the smarter play if you think about it, because why would you want to risk that much? So we're doing a little bit of a change of a plan here. A protocol with a nice threat assessment. I'm just using cooldowns now, I'm not using special abilities. Nice little disable, so he's shut down. No more Overwatch. We can position ourselves down here and kill him, and we can reposition. Just out of interest, we could reposition up here, or we can reposition up here, which is even smarter because the chance of pulling something up here is not high. Why exactly can't we do anything from up here? No one inside. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, it's still okay. No, The good thing about Fanfire is all of the shots will be resolved before he can change his form, before he can clone. So we're positioning ourselves here. Nice little shotgun to the face. Insta-kill plus nice little Overwatch. We're blocking the stairs, like I mentioned before, and we're killing this guy down there. Good. Good. Oi, Saiken, how is it going? Baron Matt, welcome to the stream. No problem at all. So for the end game, who you saw, let me do the next mission with a very, very standard tactic. So no special shit, no extra treatments, just a standard tactic. And I'll show all of you how I would do a normal run. We can, by the way, kill this guy alone. Don't need help there. Let's start beating this guy down. Just a little bit closer for the 100%. 92 is not 100. Yep, there we go. Heavy mag down. And we are pistol shooting. I'm not taking any chances. I could go 50-50 and see if we're killing it with the second shot, but I'm not. That could have been a non-crit, so it's smarter to just use lightning hands instead. Next turn we'll get the loot. And we haven't even used anything. We haven't even used anything. We only used the suit. One jump of the suit. That's all. Superior stock. Not super good. So that was 2 plus 2, no 2 plus 3, so 5 down, and I think a couple more to go. So we're keeping the high ground here. Let's just continue to move up. High ground equals good. Saiken, would it be possible to start and destroy the relay mission using blaster launcher to destroy it in the first round? No, because the blaster launcher has a maximum range, although it's pretty, pretty big. And at the moment, also, the relay has, I think, 14 hit points. So it's just outside of blaster launcher range. Don't know if it's an exploit, but I love putting a Colonel Bladestorm Ranger onto the dot with the reinforcements. That's definitely not an exploit. That is smart strategizing, my friend. Very smart strategizing. That tower here is a little bit of an exploit, but yeah. We're 8 protocoling ourselves because we can't kill all of them this turn. But we can try to take over one of the mechs, and this time I'm not going for just a stun. I want a more. Wait a second, we can't just stun it and kill the other one and then be fine. So why would I take any RNG? I would have taken it, but... Good, one down, couple more to go. I don't want to deal with the tower, so what I'm going to do is I'll just go out of line of sight. Tower can't do shit, and we're safe. Well, hello there, Sectopod. Well, now Guardian procs, but we're hurting him for only 2 hit points. That's not good. Okay, I guess we can use the Mimic Beacon this turn. Time to go nuts. And time to get rid of this sectopod here. We still want to maximize our actions since he doesn't have salvo. I'm reloading as the first action just to optimize the gameplay a little bit more. And EMP bomb as the second option here. Was it a stun? Yep, so we don't need to care about it next turn. We could kind of reposition here. Or if we're extremely aggressive, we could reposition over here. Kill the mech. Kill that guy. We don't know what's on the rooftop, so better not risk it. We can go run and gun, kill. This guy would still survive, and we would still have a tower up here, which sucks a little bit. We're going to... So now we do have everyone in vision range. This guy here, unfortunately, is going to be released next turn. I'm just thinking we could kill the tower with one shot and pretty much put him into a bad position because the mech would be here, would need to walk up and then take a shot. That's not a bad idea to use the Shredstorm cannon. If we go up to here, we can Shredstorm, but we can't flank this guy. No, that's not good. We could go to here. We'd still be in full cover. Yeah, that's better. then kill these guys and also use the X to kill him. So movement. Wow, the X movement is really, really low. The X to hit is really, really low. This kill, this one here would be better. I like it. We could go for another hit and then Shredstorm. Probably not too bad. Shredstorm. No, we don't need to use all of our abilities now because the Mimic Beacon will take care about that. I don't want to try to kill them in one turn. If we're rage hitting him, then we can kill him this turn, which means the Mimic Beacon will get all of the attention. Nice little damage, by the way. Uh-oh. Oh-oh. Or let's call it oopsie. Not cool. Throw the X. Good. That's one guy down. So, should have just stayed back. Like, that was a really bad move. One example of a learning effect where you shouldn't have gone for the kill. Let's move back. I still want to kill the tower and injure Wait a second. I do have an idea. We move over here and then Shredstorm. He would be shredded and we could even kill this we could even kill him. That would be nice. Moving to here and killing him. Moving to here into full cover even better. Wait a second. What's the best angle? Hitting all of them would be nice, but that would require us to stand somewhere like here. No, wouldn't work out. This here is a two-man hit. But wait a second. We could kill him, but that would require him to take Fanfire and go all out on him, which means we wouldn't have anyone else for the Mimic Beacon. Bad. Really bad. Full cover it is. And I don't want to take too many hits here. So we're killing the tower and we're killing, almost killing the mech, which took some nice falling damage, so we're fine. If we move to here, well, it's no longer in vision range, but it would have been nice. We could reposition up here, but that's without any cover. If we reposition up here, free shot kill. Move over here, throw down Mimic Beacon. That's an option. Do we have another one? We could basically go in here. That wouldn't be bad either, but I fear that this is a little bit too aggressive. Very simple. Can he see? Yeah, he can see him, so there shouldn't be any reason why you can't see him from there. Icarus jump to here. Lightning hands shot. Kills this guy. Good job. We can even kill one more. This gentleman over here can die. Oh, he's executed. All right. Wonderful. Either reposition or take an extra shot. I think we're going for the extra shot to deal some more damage to the sector pod. The Mimic Beacon will need to tank 1, 2, 3, 4. Wow, lots of shots. So full cover it is. Let's start softening up that guy, because next turn we want to kill him. And the less hit points he has, the better. And I think if we're placing the Mimic Beacon like over here, then the sector pod might run next to it, which is great, because then the sector pods will deal damage to one another. Good, everyone's in full cover. He's going to give everyone extra hit points. I wasn't expecting to have a fight against two sector pods. But we have brought a second EMP grenade, And guess what's even better than stunning one sector pod? Damn right, stunning two sector pods. What up? There we go. Shut down. Great. We still have a mimic beacon. And we have a lot of enemies. I mean, if we would face off from here, like that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 shots. Okay, let's set up. If we position ourselves like here, down here, and we're pulling someone with a Viper leash, then he'll take an extra hit from Blade Master. But we could also simply go here and hack away these fools as they run past us. Since we put a mimic beacon down here, that shouldn't be a problem. We could go here. That's probably more reasonable, but they would still, if we put the mimic beacon like down here, they would probably, yeah, move. So let's make room. This one position goes over here. Our healer goes down to here.
Understood. Moving out.
Takes the frostbite. Oh shit. Should have. I thought the 39% would only mean whether or not he can grab him. I wasn't aware that it's an actual hit chance. Let's not do that. We're waiting for the face-off first. The problem is he still has too much armor. Not all of these guys have too much armor. That's a little bit problematic. But yeah, let's go for the face-off first. I'm still trying to wiggle down that one sector pod here. Slowly but surely. And now we're facing off. Face-off will remove the shields, even. Even if he has a lot of armor. We could go on Overwatch and hope for additional shots, but that probably will not work out. So let's just try to get this guy down here. Was grapple a free action in XCOM 1? Yes, it was. Let's move over. I'm thinking about what's the most clever way to put it, because they will try to move towards it. I would want them to go into this direction. Hence, I think putting it here is not too bad, because then they will just move up. Next round, we'll have a frost bomb for more crowd control. Apparently, the sector pod cannot be controlled the second turn. That's really bad. I was hoping that this would not be the case. Okay, so we might take some shots. Yeah, we're flanked, so he's definitely going to hit. Gosh, you need to hit with your blade. For fuck's sake. That is still cover. And apparently he burns. So, do we have any more mimic beacons? No, we're out of mimic beacons. So from now on, it's full man mode. From now on, it's full man mode. We need to kill the sector pods because they are dealing by far the most damage. The way we could do it is we could shred him. And then there is a realistic chance that the fanfare will actually kill him. So that's one option. This guy still needs a couple of hits. Killing someone also will give us untouchable for the first shot. So maybe like going here, killing this guy will help us to effectively quote unquote tank. Do we have any more abilities left over? We could frost grenade, but that will just remove one of his actions, so he will still have a second action. Thinking about it, it might be worth it because this guy cannot act as well. And taking out two is not a bad trade. So if we frost grenade him, and he's kind of out of the game for now, we can move to here, kill him. We can kill this guy easy. And we could... No, we could not kill this guy. No grappling hook. But if we deal enough damage against him, wait a second, we could just explode that guy. So we can kill this guy with the sniper, we can kill this guy, and we can kill the sector pod. Okay, two down. We can move to here, kill this guy, three down. We can then, because he's the only one being flanked, give him a protocol for threat assessment, because this sector it will take one shot. And it will also give us a retaliation. Yeah, I think that's how we're going to do it, guys. Fire a pistol and explode that guy. Good. Fan fire and kill that sector pod. One down. We could also just go here, kill this guy, because we have untouchable, and that sector pod might take a shot at her. Yeah, that's a smart idea. Effectively offering her as bait. 100%, shotgun to the face. Good, untouchable. And frost bomb. Get ready for a surprise. Wow, can't believe we're fighting two sector pods with four men. All right, last but not least, aid protocol here for threat assessment. Good, that was the untouchable. Now, unfortunately, the next shot is going to hit. But the sector pod decides to do something really, really stupid, which I wouldn't have done in this case. But who am I to tell the sector pod what he has to do and what he hasn't? We could get both of them. The nice little fat grenade, and it would also shred. Shredding him elsewise? No, I think the grenade is the better option. And just for the record, let's move to here. Good. Shredded them pretty, pretty good. I can tell you, the sector pod needs to die this turn. Not sure though if it is happening. Here's the thing, if we haywire protocol him and stun him again, that would be fucking hilarious. Alright, I'm in. 65, that's good. No, we're not frostbiting him. He would lose again a single action. We're going all the way. Reload. Yes, please. Have our protocol and stun him. Come on, shut down. Yes. Nice one. This, by the way, will still go off. Just in case you wonder. Such a lovely fight. Oh, now they've patched it. Normally it goes off, but now it seems as if it will go off the turn right after he finishes being stunned. Hair trigger, free action, okay. Not going to say no. Sector pod is going down. We just decided that it had been a good idea to pull 2 sector pods and 6 enemies, plus 6 enemies at the same time. So we fought 4 against 8, and we fought against a hard enemy. I guess that was good. Let's put ourselves as Blade Master in the middle of the action. We're giving ourselves also threat assessment. So that's an Overwatch. Overwatch. Reload Overwatch. And just a plain good old Overwatch. All right. Nice one. First shot. Kill. Nice one. And another kill. Fanfire. Dup, dup, dup. X-ray neutralized. Menace 1-5, we're not picking up any additional contacts to the AO. Proceed to plant the X-4 charges and move to evac. I'm trying to follow the rule that if you think it's is this a good idea, it's not. We haven't lost anyone on this mission, so there is no dead hero. There are just dead enemies. I think we have taken a little bit damage, so overall I think two of our guys have been injured. But that's it. The game sound seems a little bit lower than the normal, okay? Thanks for letting me know. We can up it one more. Save and exit. Good. All right, gents, we made it. Pretty happy that we made it out alive, and when we have pulled like the second sector pod pack, that was really, really bad. That was the point and at the session where I thought, oh gosh, maybe we need to evac. And since it's only a facility, we could have evac, to be honest, and just restarted the mission. But that fun was that fight was fun, nevertheless. We needed to take all of our resources. I think at the end we had one frost leash and everything else was used. And our sniper really, really, really did a good job. By the way, I just learned that fanfire is not ending your turn, which is making the ability even better, because next time I can just shoot and kill someone and then still throw a mimic beacon. Good, here we go. Here we go. For those of you who wonder why we are only having four guys, it's not because someone died. That is because we are doing a four-man run. So, because we have no facility at our direct reach, what I'm going to do is we're just going to make contact here, so we have the next facility in case something really strange happens with the Avatar project. Wow, we're getting a lot of missions now. Retaliation counter? No, we don't care. Supplies? I really do not care, but the mission is easy, so we might want to take this mission to show you guys how to do it. And the hidden event. Archon, officer, heavy mech, gatekeeper, mutant. Heavy mech gatekeeper. Okay, who you saw us? You were asking how do I do an endgame mission the formal good old way. And I think we're going to show you. This here is shield bearer, trooper, heavy mech, sector pod. Yeah, that could be fine. Okay. Yeah, I just realized it's not ending the turn. That makes the ability Fanfire so much better than I thought before. Good, so who you saw us? Let's assume we have a standard normal team. We're going to take one specialist. I'm re-equipping them in a second. We're taking a Grenadier. Our ranger is unfortunately wounded. I don't want to take demigod because that would kind of spoil the purpose. Let's just take ghost. She's fine. I have played with her. And she doesn't have any crazy abilities, which you wouldn't have in a normal game. And let's take a sharpshooter. So we can take any sharpshooter, literally, but let's just go with the one that we just had. Or we take the Falcon. Falcon is our other sharpshooter that we had. It's the one with serial. That's also an option. Or we just take the sharpshooter that we used before. Damn, too many kernels. Let me sort via class. So, Falcon, Kuzioric. I think it was Kuzioric. No, it was Wizard 2020. Now, finally. Okay, we're going to make armor available, make weapons available, make utility items available. Pretty simple. We're not taking any stuff that you wouldn't have available on your mission, okay? And we're doing a very, very standardized setup here. Warden armor, no specific extras. Normal plasma rifle, gremlin. Nano medkit on him so he could heal, and since we know that we're up against a lot of mechanical units, we might consider blue screen rounds on him. The other option that you could consider is the skulljack, so you can instantly kill someone, or mimic beacon, which in this case we're going to play the safest version. So let's just give him a mimic beacon. Off we go. Done. Number one. Number two, our heavy. From a loadout, I don't know, do you want to see it with a warsuit or without a warsuit? I'm fine to go with a normal weapon and a normal loadout. So EMP grenade. If you have the option, elsewise take a shredder, take an acid grenade, or take a gas grenade. And if you have none of that, just take a plasma. Let's just take a plasma grenade. Saiten, who you think is the tougher enemy, the sector port or the gatekeeper? I personally think the gatekeeper is more difficult for various reasons. He has more armor, cannot be hacked, has harder abilities, and is harder to hit, but sector port is relatively easy to hit. Good. So, who you saw, since you didn't answer, I am assuming that you're fine with going in with a heavy armor. So, we do have blaster weapon and grenades, so two grenades and two EMP grenades, which should be fine for all of the things that we're finding. As for our Ranger, Warden armor, just a normal gun, fusion blade. We'll give her another mimic beacon. And then either Talon rounds if you want to maximize your crit, or alternatively, you're going for another grenade, or alternatively, you can go for blue screen rounds, which kind of is okay as well. So it doesn't really matter here. The Ranger is not very dependent on its abilities, on its utilities. The Ranger is pretty much just a damage dealer, and your main damage will be from the shotgun. So just for the purpose of showing it, no, flashbang wouldn't make any sense because we will not face anything that we could flashbang. Flashbang could be good if you're having problems killing codices, or if you find yourself in a situation where you want to get rid of mind control. But in the end game, that really shouldn't be an issue. Good. And as for our sniper, again, very easy loadout. We want to take Warden armor. We'll take a normal weapon. Two screen rounds, beam pistol, and either mimic beacon or anything else. We can even go for a grappling hook, just to give him the option to grapple a little bit more. But yeah, that's pretty much the loadout that I would suggest you to go. So this is standard normal XCOM. Everyone could equip his guys like that. And we're now going for an endgame mission.